Hello, my name is Olivier Notz and I am responsible for the InterApp Academy. On this how-to video, we will show you how to mount a limit switch box on an actuator and how to adjust it. For this task, we need, logically, the limit switch box, including the screws, a multimeter, a Phillips screwdriver, a normal screwdriver, and a key for the screws. Before mounting the limit switch box, we need to remove the retaining screw on top of the actuator. Then, very important, we need to check that the position indicator on top of the actuator, the position indicator on the limit switch box, correspond to the position of the disc of the valve. They must look all in the same direction. On this limit switch box, we have so-called telescopic legs that we can move depending on the height of the shaft of the actuator. We have 20 millimeter or 30 millimeter, and depending on that, we are changing the position of the legs. To be faster with the mounting of the legs on the actuator, I remove them. So I can screw from the top what is much faster. So do not tight fully. Then I place the limit switch box on the legs to control everything is okay. And now I can tighten the screw completely. The correct position of the limit switch box is that the cable entry of the limit switch box looks in the same direction than the cable entry of the solenoid valves. So I mount now the box on top. Now I fix the retainers of the legs so that they cannot move anymore. And now the box is finished mounted on the actuator. Next step will be to adjust the limit switches. In standard, the limit switches are adjusted in factory at 0 and 90 degrees. In case you find problems during the installation or you want to be sure, you can readjust them on your own. First, we need to remove the cover. Please remark that the screws on the cover are not losable. So, especially when you are on site, the risk to lose a screw is very small. On the cover, you see on one side you have the schema, how to connect the limit switch boxes, and on the other, you have the type label with all the technical information. Here we see the cable entry, the terminal where to connect the cables. We see the upper cam and the lower cam and the two limit switches on top of each other. They are pre-wired, so you don't need to do anything on that. Everything is prepared. To control the connectivity, we use a multimeter to measure now the resistance. Here, you see we have a very, very high resistance, means we have no contact. And when we connect both together, the resistance falls completely to zero and we have now contact. Now we check on terminal number 1 and 2. We have connection for the closed position. Now we will control the opened position. For this, we need to operate the actuator using compressed air. The position indicator shows well the position of the disc, so the valve is fully open. Now we can make the control of the open position. The valve is now opened. We check with help of terminal 4 and 5 if the cam is properly set. And as we see on the multimeter, we have no resistance, so we can say the valve is properly set. Now, in case the signal would not be okay, we need to readjust the limit switch cam. To readjust it properly, we remove the position indicator and we see now that the end of the cam is not touching the small cam of the limit switch. It's not activated. Now, very easily, I push down the cam with my fingers. I turn it until the end of the cam is on the opposite position of the limit switch, and I let it go again, and automatically it takes the right position. And because we have very small tooth here, it remains in position, pushed up by a spring. This is not so good visible for the lower cam, but the system is exactly identical. So now the cam is properly set. Put the position indicator again in place, still not forgetting to have the same position as the disc. Now we put the cover again on the box, making sure that the schema showing the terminal is on the same side as the terminal. Thank you for watching this InterApp video. I hope it was helpful.